Hi students, this is Madhu Dharmapuri. Welcome back to the electrostatics lecture number 10. We have been discussing applications of Gauss law for the last 3 to 4 lectures. As part of it, we have calculated electric field due to point charge, calculated electric field due to charged halosphere, and calculated electric field due to uniformly charged solid sphere non-conducting. Okay, so what we have to do when you are supposed to use Gauss law for finding electric field, we need to follow certain steps. What are those steps? Identification of point where you are finding electric field due to a charge distribution, and then drawing a Gaussian surface passing through that identified point in the step 1, and then considering a small area element on that Gaussian surface at that particular point, and then drawing directions of electric field and area vector at that point, then by definition of flux using mathematical equation, calculating electric flux passing through that small area element ds, which is equal to E dot ds, and finding total electric flux passing through entire Gaussian surface, which is integral E dot ds. Then this calculated electric flux is compared with the electric flux calculation using Gauss law, which is nothing but 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by that closed surface. Then we find out electric field by comparing this electric flux calculated using definition of flux, that is mathematical equation, and total electric flux using Gauss law. Then we find out electric field. These are the steps to be followed whenever you are supposed to use Gauss law. Okay, so with this knowledge, let us move forward now to find out electric field due to another kind of charge distribution, which is very, very important. You can see it here. Electric field due to infinite line of charge distribution. Basically, you are going to find out electric field due to a linear charge distribution. What is linear charge distribution? The charge is distributed along a line. You can consider it as a wire, a thin wire, and charge is uniformly distributed along that thin wire, along its length. Then we call it as a linear charge distribution. If that wire is wire length is very, very long, and the point where you are finding electric field due to that is very close to it, the distance of point is very, very smaller than the length of the wire, then we can consider that wire as infinite wire. See, infinite wire means it need not be a wire with length infinity. You can consider it as a long wire or infinite wire when it is compared that the length of the distribution or charge distribution or wire is very long when you are compared to the distance of the point where you are finding electric field. Remember this point. Okay, so we are going to find out electric field due to infinite line of charge distribution, means a very long line along which a charge is distributed uniformly, and due to that, how much is the electric field at a particular point nearby it? That is our aim. Okay, so you can see this picture. Here I have drawn a long wire which is considered as an infinite length wire, minus infinity to plus infinity, on which the charge, here I have considered positive charge, a positive charge is linearly distributed along its length. So whenever this charge is distributed along its length, we call it as linear distribution. So linearly distributed. How much? The charge is not given here. What is given? A linear charge density is given. That is lambda, you can see. A long line charge with a linear charge density lambda. So here, the direct this much of charge is distributed. It is not given like that. What is given? Linear charge density is given. If linear charge density is given, what does that mean? It is nothing but the charge per unit length is given. That means in 1 meter length of this wire, in 1 meter length of this wire, what is that? Lambda is charge per unit length. How much charge is distributed? That is given. In 1 meter length of this wire, how much charge is distributed is given. That is what? Lambda. Right? So, 1 meter, in 1 meter length, how much charge is distributed? That is nothing but lambda. Then in entire length, for example, L meter length, how much charge? L into lambda. Okay, so this is how you have to understand the problem. And we have to calculate electric field at a point, a distance r from the line charge. See here. This is the point identified, which is at a distance of small r from the charge distribution. The step one. Whenever you are supposed to use Gauss law, you have to follow some steps I said, right? That first step is this only. The identification of point which is at a distance of small r from linear charge distribution. So here, I have to find out electric field. At a point which is at a distance of small r from the linear charge distribution. Or a wire. This is the problem given to us. So before we find out electric field by using all these steps and using Gauss law, first let me explain you about the electric field direction due to a point charge as well as a line charge distribution. Because we need electric field directions to find out electric flux, E dot ds. What is the angle between E and ds? Whether it is 0 or 90 or some other angle. So you need to have the direction of E, right? One of the steps of using Gauss law. Right? So for that, we need to know what is the direction of electric field due to this charge distribution. Right? So for that, first let me tell you. For example, I have a charge plus here. Okay, of any magnitude. I have a charge plus, the positive charge. We know that electric field direction due to a point positive charge, this is considered it is a point charge, is always away from the positive charge. This is how it looks like. We already know this. I have discussed about this already in previous video lectures. So this is how electric field direction will look like. It is always away from a positive charge. For example, I can just show you this way. So this is how it goes. For example, if this is the center of positive charge, this way, this is positive charge, and it goes away from it like this in all directions. Okay, now for example, if which means it's a radial kind of electric field direction, and now if I have a line charge like this, as shown in this picture, plus here, plus here, plus here, plus here, a charge is distributed along its line. like a lambda linear charge density is
distributed.
Then if I want electric field at this point, due to this wire, I have to consider all these charges linearly distributed, right? For example, the electric field at this point due to this is how much? So actually this should be this way. Actually electric field at this point due to this is how much? This way. Electric field at this point due to this is how much? This way. So this is how electric field. Electric field, for example, this is plus, electric field at this point is how much? This is how. Now if I consider only one of this, like this, for example, I have a point here. If I consider this charge, its direction is this way. So if my point is here, this way, this should be resolved into two components. This is x component, this is y component. And similarly, opposite to this, for example, this charge, this will have electric field direction this way. This is again resolved into two components, and that resolved component is again now along this, and this y component will be this way, Ey. Now if you observe these two, this Ey components are opposite to each other, they cancel each other, and Ex components are in the same direction. See, due to this, the Ex is this way, due to this, Ex is this way. So X components are adding up, Y components are cancelling each other. Which means that electric field at this particular point due to this charge or due to this charge is this way. Because vertical components are cancelled. Similarly, all this electric field due to this one at this point is this way. At this point, electric field at this point due to this is again this way. See, this is at a distance of r, this is at a distance of r, and this is a positive charge. This is also away from positive charge, this is also away from positive charge. On this side, it will be this way. On this side, it will be this way. On this side, it will be this way. On all these points, here, 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 here also, this side. So due to this charge distribution, on this side it is going this, on this side it is going this. So this is how electric field direction is. Electric field direction. This side it was, this was this side, and that side. And what about back side? I am not able to show you. But back side and this side. That side it will be in this way. It goes away from positive charge. See, so if this is my wire, for example, and this side the electric field direction is this. And if the point is here, its direction is this. If point is here, its direction is this. If point is here, its direction is this. If point is here, its direction is this. Always away from it because it is a positive charge. Right? If my point is here and electric field direction at that particular point will be this. How this? Because Y components are cancelling, X components are adding. X component means what? Horizontal. So that is why I kept this in the horizontal direction. Similarly, opposite side. See, whatever may be the length of this wire, if I select a point, if that point is here, the electric field direction at that particular point due to any charge on this wire will be in this way or in this way, in this way, in this way. Okay, so I will show you front view and top view for this. You will see that front view means if you see from here, if the wire is here, it will be like if this is wire plus 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 plus, electric field direction is this way. This is front view. If you see from here. But don't think that only these two are there. See, it is observed like this. But don't think that there is an electric field direction this way also. It is there. Electric field direction is also this side. Also this side. But you cannot see them. But if you can see top view, for example, if I see from here like this. So top view. Then it looks like if this is plus 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 plus, you don't see this from top view, you don't see this whole wire, you will see only one top charge. If you are looking from here, you will see only one top charge, not all this, right? That will be like this. Top view in all directions. Top view in all direction. It will be looking like this. Top view. This is front view. If I see from here only, you will see these two. But if I see from top, you will see all these. Which means what you have to understand from here is electric field direction is always away from a positive charge in this way. Means what is electric field direction at this particular point? This way. If I select another point at the same distance to this side, what is electric field direction? This side, this way. If I select another point back side at the same distance, what will be the electric field direction? That will be this way, towards my side. If I select another point at this particular point, this side, imagine 3D picture, then its direction will be this way. Which means, around this wire, you can imagine a cylinder. Around this wire, you can imagine a cylinder. How? See, for example, if this is a wire, if this is wire, on which charge distributed linearly. Imagine this is in cylindrical shape. I have got this toy to explain you. Imagine this is in cylindrical shape. Okay, so this wire is like this. And on the surface of this cylinder, if you consider a point, and that point is equidistant from the wire, any point you consider on this cylinder, this side or this side or this side or this side, all are distance from the wire because symmetric cylindrically, right? Here the electric field direction is this way, here electric field direction is this way, here electric field direction is this way, here electric field direction is this way, but all these points are equidistant from the wire. And all these at all these points, electric field value is same because they are equidistant. See, wire is here. If I want electric field at this point, it is same. At this point, it is same. At this point, it is same because all are at same distance from the wire. See, cylinder radius is R every time. So this you have to understand here. So why I have shown you this is, I am going to draw a Gaussian surface here in cylindrical shape. Okay, the step one is what? Step one is identification of point at a distance of R. What is step two? Drawing a Gaussian surface passing through that point, symmetric about charge distribution. Then what is the shape of Gaussian surface? For the sphere case, we have drawn spherical Gaussian surface. Right? Even for point charge, we have drawn a spherical Gaussian surface. But for this line charge distribution, what is the shape of Gaussian surface? I can take a cylindrical Gaussian surface. Because I have shown you how and why. Because if I consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface around this line charge, and on the surface of this this cylinder, everywhere electric field remains same, because the surface of that cylinder is equidistant from the wire. All sides. Okay? So this we have to understand. I am removing this, you can copy it. It is important, front view and top view, electric field direction. For I can see this is electric field direction, E and E, top view and front view. Okay, now we will calculate electric field. Sorry, electric field due to this charge distribution. So what is our second step now? What is our second step? Drawing a Gaussian surface around this charge distribution. So I am going to draw a Gaussian surface in cylindrical shape. This is my Gaussian surface now. This is Gaussian surface in cylindrical shape. Okay, so of radius you can say, and this Gaussian surface can be, let me write it here. Draw a Gaussian surface in cylindrical shape of radius R passing through point P of any arbitrary length L. What is the length of the cylinder I am talking about? Any arbitrary length. We can consider any length, because the charge is distributed uniformly along the line. In one unit length, you will find out what is the charge. So you don't need how much is the length. Arbitrary length. Any arbitrary length L, which means the length of this cylinder is L. Let me write it here. Okay, so we have drawn a Gaussian cylinder of radius R and length L passing through that point P. Okay, then what is the next step? Choosing a small area element and drawing directions of electric field and the area element. Right? So for this, because it is in cylindrical shape, you have different kinds of surfaces, you see. So this is a flat surface for cylinder, you can see. See, for example, if you see this, this is cylindrical in shape. This is a flat surface. Right? This is curved surface. And this is again flat surface. So for a cylinder you have two curved surfaces or two flat surfaces and one curved surface. It's not spherical in shape, it is cylindrical. So you need to calculate electric flux part wise. What is electric flux passing through flat surface? What is electric flux passing through curved surface? And what is the total electric flux passing through Gaussian surface? This is how you have to calculate. Okay, so that we will do now. For example, if I consider these parts as, you can say this is curved surface is my part 1 and this is 2 and this is 3. So two flat surfaces, 2 and 3, curved surface is 1. Right? If I consider one small area element here on the curved surface, then electric field direction is obviously this way, and ds is all obviously this way on the curved surface. And what about this flat surface? If I consider a small area element on this flat surface, electric field direction is, let me take this side only, this is flat surface, electric field direction is this, see electric field direction is this side, right? Right? And what is direction of area now? Ds is this. See, for this top flat surface, direction of area is this, right? And electric field direction is this only. I have told you already what is electric field direction. What about here? Electric, this is Ds. This is E. For this surface, electric field direction is this. And electric, the area vector direction is this. And electric field direction is this side, perpendicular to it. Right? So this is how you have to understand. Now what is total electric flux? Sorry, electric flux, total electric flux will be pi equal to pi 1 plus pi 2 plus pi 3. Electric flux passing through curved surface, electric flux passing through flat surface, electric flux passing through bottom flat surface. So this is how you have to calculate. So in the previous cases, sphere cases, we didn't have pi 2, pi 3. Pi is nothing but simply integral E dot ds. Because only one spherical surface. But here we have three kinds of surfaces. We have to divide them. Pi 1, pi 2, pi 3. Okay. So what is pi 1 now? Pi 1 is flux passing through curved surface. Right? What is pi 2? Flux passing through a top flat surface. What is pi 3? Same, bottom flat surface. Okay, so now let us write what is pi 1 and what is pi 2 and what is pi 3. Then we will calculate total pi. So what is pi 1? Pi 1 is equal to how much? If I take pi 1 means entire curved surface, right? That should be integral E dot ds here, curved surface, this one. See, if I take only this area, it is E dot ds, but I want entire curved surface, right? So integral E dot ds. If I want only flux passing through this area element, it is E dot ds. But if I want electric flux passing through entire curved surface, it should be integral E dot ds. What is E direction? What is BS direction? Both are in the same way. See, parallel to each other. So it is nothing but integral EDS cos 0, which is integral EDS, right? What is E here? Electric field on the curved surface. Electric field at a point means what? Where is this point? This point is on the curved surface, right? Electric field is on the curved, electric field at a point P, which is on the curved surface. And here what is electric field? This is on the curved surface. Same, right? Same distance. Here what is electric field? Same. Here what is electric field? Same. Here what is electric field? Same. What is here? Electric field? Same. All are equidistant. I have shown you already. Everywhere electric field will be same because every point is equidistant from wire. That is why I have drawn the cylindrical shape Gaussian surface. Which means E is same everywhere on cylinder or Gaussian surface, you can say. Everywhere on Gaussian surface. Because it is in cylindrical shape. Right? So that I can write pi 1 is equal to E integral CS DS. Curved surface CS means. E is written out of the integral. Right? What is integral DS? Integral DS means surface area of this curved surface. Surface area of this curved surface. What is surface area of curved surface? Integral ds is surface area of curved surface. How much? It should be equal to 2 pi r into L. Remember this. Pi r means its circumference, its circumference and its length L. Its circumference, see, generally area means what? Length into width. Length is L. Width is how much? 2 pi r. Width is 2 pi r, length is L. 2 pi r into L. Length into width is area, right? That is how I have written 2 pi r L. So this can be written as E into 2 pi RL. What is this E into 2 pi RL? Flux passing through curved surface. Flux passing through curved surface. We have written flux passing through curved surface. We have not written pi 2, pi 3 till now. We have written only pi 1. Pi 1 only written. Pi 2, pi 3 we have not discussed till now. Okay. What is pi 2? Pi 2 is the flux passing through top flat surface. And it is very simple that you can see from the picture. It will be integral flat surface E dot ds is integral flat surface EDS cos 90, which is equal to 0. E is this, DS is this, 90 degrees. You can see this. 0. Similarly, here, you can say here top flat surface. Here it is bottom flat surface. E dot DS is again bottom flat surface. EDS cos 90, which is equal to 0. So this is 90. So pi 2 is 0, pi 3 is 0, only pi 1 is E into 2 pi RL. Which means that total electric flux pi E is now how much? is equal to pi 1. Okay, so now we substitute all these in this equation. Then we will get pi is equal to e into 2 pi rl plus 0 plus 0, which is nothing but pi e equal to e into 2 pi rl. So this is the electric flux passing through Gaussian surface, total electric flux passing through Gaussian surface. See, pi is passing through Gaussian surface. Total electric flux passing through Gaussian surface, pi equal to e into 2 pi rl. This, by definition of flux, by using mathematical equation, we have calculated this. What is the next step now? We have to compare this with Gauss law. What Gauss law is saying? The total electric flux passing through Gaussian surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed by the Gaussian surface. Right? So that is what Gauss law. So now we will use Gauss law. Remember this value, total electric flux passing through Gaussian surface is this much, and from Gauss law total electric flux passing through Gaussian surface pi e equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed by Gaussian surface. What is Gaussian surface here? This dotted cylinder in drawn in dotted lines. Right? Then how much is the charge enclosed by Gaussian surface? How much is the charge enclosed by this? Is it given anywhere? How much is the charge? Is it given anywhere like Q charge is distributed? It's not given like that, right? What is given? Linear charge distribution with linear charge density lambda. That is what given. Right? So, linear charge density is how much? In one lambda charge, lambda linear charge density I can say charge is linearly distributed with the linear charge density. Right. Charge is linearly distributed with linear charge density lambda, which is equal to charge per unit length. It's a lambda which is equal to charge per unit length, which means in 1 meter length lambda charge is distributed. See, charge by length, lambda is what? Charge by length. In 1 meter length, how much is charge? Lambda. In 1 meter length, lambda charge is distributed. Then in n meter length, lambda l charge is distributed. See, in 1 meter length, if length is equal to 1, charge is equal to lambda. In L meter, see, our Gaussian surface is L meter length. Then in L meter length, lambda into L. See, in 1 meter, it is lambda. In 2 meters, 2 lambda. In 3 meters, 3 lambda. In 10 meters, 10 lambda. In L meters, L lambda. So lambda L charge is distributed in L length. Means that is lambda L is charge enclosed by Gaussian surface. Lambda L is charge enclosed by Gaussian surface. That means pi equal to 1 by epsilon naught times into lambda L. So this, let us say equation 1, this is equation 2. 1 and 2 are same. Right? 1 and 2 are same. Now let us equate them. Copy this. Right? So 1 and 2 are same. So now I will write. From 1 and 2, E into 2 pi RL is equal to lambda L by epsilon naught. This is equal to this. Then E is equal to lambda L by 2 pi. You can see, let me cancel this first. This L will cancel with this and we will be left with lambda by 2 pi R epsilon naught and E proportional to 1 by R distance. E proportional to 1 by R. This is electric field due to uniformly infinite line. Infinite line of charge, you can say. Uniformly charged infinite line. The electric field due to infinite line of charge distribution, whatever, both are same. Electric field due to infinite line of charge distribution, but charge distribution is uniform. This is the answer for this question. And E proportional to 1 by R. Right? And graphical representation for this is, see, we are drawing graph for every answer. So graphical representation for this is R and this is E and this is like this, E proportional to R, 1 by R, E proportional to 1 by R. Rectangular hyperbola. Okay, so this is how you have to calculate electric field due to this linear charge distribution. Okay, so hope you have understood. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, you can put your doubts under the comment section. Thank you very much.